Hey, I'm Biglaw, and I'm going to be doing some just IL tutorials. This is 2020, July 2020. So most of what you're going to see is going to be up to date in comparison to Rushi's tutorial back in from 2018. So we'll just kind of go into things. So you may think it's just the start of the game. There's no speed tech. Well, you start, and right after you skip this cutscene, you want to press your switch stance button to enter pressure stance. And what that does is that it'll immediately allow you to start skipping forward. Whereas if you were just in normal standing stance, you'd have that bit of a slow kickoff. So just entering the switch, the pressure stance will get you immediately going. So let's skip the dialogue, and now you're faced with the jump. So ideally you want to jump onto the porch like so. And something that I see a lot of runners not really know how to do is to get the delayed ollie, or the Wilhelm time to get to the second piece. So you just want to run a whole day. I messed it up myself. I'm bad. But you want a whole day, and you can get that extra jump in the air and make it to the truck right there.
Thanks. Here's your deck back. Hey, while I'm getting my ride set up again.
So now we're into the second part of the tutorial bit. So I like to go here and do a bit of a grind so we can get to the barriers faster. So boneless grind, jump over the barriers, and like that, boom. And there's that timer there. And if you can hit A at the right time, you can pretty much skip it instantly, but if not, it's all right. So yeah, here you want to just back here. But yeah, so here, get off your board, get on your board, jump off board, back on board, manual, into the combo over to, I believe it's Sean over here. But yeah, it's important to get the 7.5k so you have maximum speed.
You suck to see Musk's demo?
So now we're on to the flyers, and this mission is pretty fun. So you'll notice that I'm doing these specific grinds, like the Creel slides, the Dark slides, whatever, and those slides will give you a little bit of extra speed. So just try to implement them wherever you can when grinding around, because it's just a very small speed increase. Yeah, the flyer route is just you follow these flyers here. I like to do some jumps just so I can get a little bit of extra speed. Jump through here, and then you're done with that. And now you talk to our boy JT here.
Hey, JT. Hey, the kid next door.
Nah, so yeah, it's gonna be similar to what we do with Eric at the start of the run, where we want to enter our pressure stance right away so we can go start walking the dog immediately. And here it's just holding on to the dog. You didn't see that. Holding on to the dog for as long as you need to. So you're done with that. And then you just open up the menu, and menu down to get in tight with the Street Warriors. So yeah, the driving is pretty whack. You can see my inputs, so you'll have a good idea as to what you need to be doing. This corner here, you want to let go of acceleration, right? Okay, I'm just gonna redo this, because I wanna show off the Hecky Bounce. The Hecky Bounce is basically, can maintain our momentum going around this corner by just slamming into the fence, like that. And you just need to release acceleration right before you hit the fence. So that was found by Hecky, and he's pretty cool. Now hopefully we can do something here called Street Warrior Skip. And what it is you hit Ollie at the right time here.
You're nuts. Hey,
As you saw on the input display, I was trying to hit it, but if you hit all at the same moment a dialogue starts, then you'll just skip that one piece of dialogue. You can see it at the start of some missions where, like, you load in and then you'll be on the second piece of dialogue. It's pretty much that. It's most beneficial on one dialogue situations, like right there with JT. Yeah, hit A twice and then you talk to Joey. No need to menu. Now this mission right here is pretty difficult. You do bonus 180 judo into a Madonna. You need to manual as well to maintain the combo. Some people like to do flatland and stuff like that. I didn't even get 10k. But yeah, like that's acceptable, but the fastest thing you can do is just that real quick, or even... Like that's... Like something like that is also pretty fast. But anyways, we'll move on to this new chapter, Impression. Let's see if you guys... This is pretty easy, so you just want to get off your board here. Now this transfer can be a little bit tricky for some people. I personally... This is what I do. Whenever you start going down, you can see I'm just holding back so you can just be in the position. But basically, whenever I get a little bit more than halfway down the ramp, I start to hold left or hold right, and then I can transfer. Now here, you don't want to ollie or anything. You just want to do your spine transfer in foot, and then go straight to Joey.
With Joey, right?
Hey, yeah, all three of those guys were in the same stuff. Anyways, this is a pretty cool mission. So here, instead of doing a spine transfer, you hold forward and acid drop into the trash. You do the same thing here, except you do a trick. I have the cat bags bound, so it'll be nut buster and cat bags here as well. And if you don't know what cat bags are, then I'm sure it'll be explained in the tutorial, but it should be in like the setup tutorial, pretty much. Anyways, demo the new playground setup.
So you want to be sponsored, huh? Got, yeah.
So there's a number of ways you can go about doing this mission. Personally, the way I like to do it is I just do a bonus 180 judo into here and then do a mix it up. But some people like to do something like that. It's a pretty cool strat. But I just do what I'm comfortable with. So here you just match the dialogue, and usually you'd say, okay, I'm gonna go along this way. But the fastest way to do things is just to run this way and interact with this vehicle, get in, retry the last goal, and now you have your skateboard. Pretty cool strat. So no menuing, just talk to Eric immediately. Eric, okay? And again, enter the pressure stance so you can start skating immediately. Jump onto here, and here we're going to do our first butt slap of the run. So just do a double butt slap up to that piece of junk. And grind, get to the next house, and don't feel bad if you don't get this butt slap, I missed it a ton. But this butt slap... Yeah, I only got a double there. A good backup, if you missed that butt slap there, is to just do a boneless up this ramp. I'm just gonna go for the butt slap here, just so I can kind of show off what it's like. So, jump over here. There we go. Okay, so there is a huge number of ways to go about doing this mission right here. So you can do it the normal way, where you just ride around on the back of the car all the way around the block, which is admittedly very slow. There's the first version of Bridge Kit, which I'm going to show off right now. So you go here, shuffle here, jump here. I think if you do a boneless, you can make it. But best to just try and go for some butt slaps. Yeah, like that. No problem. There is Bridge Kit V2, which, just jump down here into the pool, jump again. And a double should make it no problem. Well, something to note is that every time you retry this goal, you will have to get a bit further after the first retry, because the margin for failure, it goes from, instead of like being like like a little bit beyond where the cops are. Like, you have to go a lot further back in order to actually make the jump, which is silly, but whatever. And then the way I do it is a brisket V3, which you do this, and you do like a quad butt slap. It is very, very over the top and not very beginner friendly, I'll fully admit. You gotta get good at butt slaps if you want to make those kinds of jumps. But now, on to the end of chapter 3. Getting access to the train station. We gotta talk to Stu here, and there are some jumps here to activate the golden round goal, so let's just do it the normal way. So you get to get around to a goal, but there's a way to do it a lot faster than just going around twice. So along this shape, it's not really a circle, but if you jump about here and jump around here, you can activate the goal, or the gap. So that's a bit off on that one. Hello? I'm just mad right now. Alright, right there. And it'd be like right around here as well, so I'm just gonna try to go fat again. There we go. There we go. If you've made it fast enough, you can have the pork appear when talking to the Bratty Kid here. So there's a number of ways you can go about doing this goal. You could just do like Bolsonaro Judo into bumping into the wall to immediately end your combo. Or you can do an anti-Casper into a Judo. I did a Madonna there because I had the manual pop up, but this is the fast way. So okay. Now the end of the chapter. Eric Skip is definitely a big gatekeeper in the run, and all I can really say is you just need to practice and get your timing down as to when you need to jump. So go here, sketch onto the back of the car, and try and jump after the gas passes the car. And that is Eric Skip and New Jersey. So thank you for watching, and hopefully I make some more of these. I enjoy just kind of going through this and taking things one step at a time. But yeah, New York's probably the next thing to come up, so thank you for watching, and good luck with running.